Hi everyone. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to set up Heron Copier. It's pretty easy to set up. Should only take less than 3 minutes, I would say, if you follow everything correctly. So let's just go ahead. First of all, of course, you have to download the copier first. You can just go to the website and then click on this Get Started button, which will automatically scroll the page down to this section. You can just click on the download button on this free version section right here. It doesn't matter if you have a license because the license key will just simply unlock the features when it gets validated. When you click this button, your browser will already start downloading the file that the copier needs. And once the download is finished, you can just open this file. Now, once you have opened the zip file, I would just recommend you to copy or extract this folder, this entire folder, to the desktop folder so that you can find it easily. Right, so let's wait a bit until all the files are extracted. All right, so once the extraction has finished, you can go to that folder that you just extracted and you can run this MSI installer file. Just right click and click install. You may get this sort of like warning from Windows. It's just simply because our app is not registered, it's not officially registered. So that's why it is said that this app is unrecognized. But no worries, you can just click on more info and then click run anyway. All right, so once this connector app is installed, you can simply click on the installer tab right here and then just click the install button. This will install the EAs to three platforms at least, MT4, MT5, and cTrader. Now, for the rest of the platforms, TradeLocker, DXtrade, and MatchTrader, you don't need to run any EAs because the copier are in the form of executable file. So you can just directly run the copier afterwards. I will just show you. For now, let's click install. You will get this successful message appearing on the connector app. It just simply means that the EA has been installed properly to all the platforms. Now you can just check your platform. For example, this one, MT5, and then just right click on the expert advisors tab and then click refresh. Now you will see a new folder. This folder is the one that was just installed by this installer right here. Okay. Right. So I will go on to show you how to set up the copier quickly to copy from one platform to another six platforms. In this case, what I'm planning to use is that I'm planning to use this one MT5 account as the master account, copying to the other platforms. So they are MT4, and then cTrader, DXtrade, MatchTrader, and TradeLocker, right? So since this account, this platform will be used as the master account, we need to set up more permissions. So you can go to the tools, options, and make sure that you have filled all these options. Algorithmic trading, DLL import, and also allow the web request for our website, right? So once you have done that, you can just simply drag the master EA to this chart. It doesn't matter where you attach the EA to. You can just simply attach it to any EAs, and any trades you made on every pairs will be copied anyway, right? I'm going to put my license key here. This is just my test license key for developers, but you should input your own license key. I will just use the default options for now and just click OK. You will see the status on the label, say it says connecting right now, but as soon as it turns to surface running, it means that this account is ready to be used. Now I will just open the connector app again and then lock myself in by inputting the license key here, because I would like to first access the dashboard. I would like to confirm or verify if at least my master account is connected properly. Like so, right? So now it's there. The master account is there. I'm going to proceed to set up the rest of the slave accounts. Let's go with the first slave account, which is an MT5 slave account, right? Since the EA is installed already, I can just simply drag the slave EA to the chart. I will just use default options for now. I really don't care about all these different settings for now. I just would like to have my trades copied with the default setting, which uses lot multiplier with a value of 1, which means that everything will be copied as is. I'm going to click OK for now. It says connecting, and it will soon turn to connected, right? Once it is connected, you can expect to see your account appearing on this chart, on this dashboard. Like so. Now we got our first slave account connected. I'm going to just click slave. I'm going to just drag the slave EA to the chart. I'm just going to rename it MT4 slave number 2. You can actually rename your account however you want, it doesn't matter. But for just to avoid confusion later on, because we will have like 6 accounts later as slave accounts, it's always a good practice to at least use some numbers in this field. I'm going to just put the default settings again. Just would like to have them connected for now. It's connecting. And now it's connected. So we can always check if our accounts are connected from the dashboard, like so. Next would be the cTrader slave account. I'm going to do the exact same stuff like before, which is the attachment of the slave EA to the chart. So this would be my slave number 3. And I'm going to start it. It's connected now. So let's see, it should be appearing in the dashboard soon. Right, it's there. We have slave number 1, slave number 2, and then slave number 3. I will go on with the rest of the platforms. Let's go to the desktop folder where we extracted the zip file. And for my 4th slave account, I would like to set up a DXtrade account. Now, when you open the DXtrade account, DXtrade folder, you will see 2 different executable files, the master and slave. And since we have already set up an MT5 account as the master account, it only makes sense for us to run the 2nd executable file, which is the one that is intended to be run for the slave account. Again, same steps, more info, run anyway. Now let's wait a bit until the copier app starts. All right. So supposedly, you'd have to fill all these fields with your credentials that your prop firm or broker has given to you. But since I have already saved my profile, I'm just going to click on load profile and just load it from this file. These are the settings that I have saved before. All right, so I'm going to just start the EA right away. Now it's connected, let's see. Oh, I forgot to rename my slave account, sorry. Slave number 5. I think it's number 5, right? No, it's number 4. All right, I just start it back up again. Now it's connected. So let's wait until, oh, never mind, it's there, right? I'm going to do the same with the MatchTrader slave account, which would be my 5th slave account. Same process like before, but since I have already saved my profile, I can just easily click on the file and then load profile. So this should be it. Now it's green. Again, I always forget to rename my account. This should be my 5th slave account. It's connected. Let's see if it would appear here very soon. Now it's there, right? So I have first slave account on MT5, second slave account on MT4, third slave account on cTrader, fourth slave account on DXtrade, and then fifth slave account on MatchTrader, and then the last slave account would be on TradeLocker. All right. So I should have my profiles right here. So this should be my sixth slave account. I'm going to click OK now and then connect. One setting that I noticed that may not be correct for this account. So I just have to fix some stuff, some small stuff in here. Right, so let's see how many accounts are connected now. One master account and then six slave accounts. Now, what I'm going to do now is that I'm just going to open the trade on my master account. Sorry, it seems that I have already a running trade here on my slave account. I'm just gonna close it for now. All right. I will explain later what this button does, but for now I just would like to start with a clean state where I have zero positions opened. Alright? Alright, so I just refreshed the dashboard just to make sure that we are starting with a clean state, in the sense that there should not be running positions because we would like to test the copying operation, right? So what I would do is that I will start opening a trade on my master account, and I would expect to have the trade getting copied to all other slave accounts. So let's just go ahead. This is my master account, and all right. So I just would like to make sure that we are starting with a clean state, in the sense that there should not be any running positions. Now, as you can see, the floating PNLs are zero, which means that all these accounts didn't have running positions. What I'm going to do now is that I'm going to just open the trade on my master account, and I would expect to have that trade getting copied to all other slave accounts, right? So let's just go ahead. This is my master account. I'm just going to open a small trade here, and once the trade is open on my master account, the same trade should be copied to all other slave accounts, like so. And the dashboard, it should also reflect the changes. So if you go to the dashboard now, you'll see that the PNLs are getting updated. Now, if I close these positions, then all the slave accounts will also try to close their positions, like so, right? So I think that's all. It's really easy to set up the copier. Now, what we have just done is that we just set up one master account copying to six slave accounts. What I would like to show you next is the features on the dashboard, because the dashboard is not only like a centralized place where you configure your accounts, but you can also sort of like control the copier from the dashboard. So let's just say that you would like to close certain positions only on certain slave accounts. Of course, what you can do is that you can just go to each of the slave accounts and then logging into that account and then close the positions. For example, hey, I would like to close all these positions that were copied from slave account to my MT4 account. I don't want to have these positions running anymore, but you don't want to do it from the master account because that would mean that all your other slave accounts will also close these positions, right? So what you can do is that you can log into this MT4 account and close the trades manually, like literally closing all these positions. You can actually do that from the dashboard. What you can do is that from the dashboard, there is a kill switch button right here. So currently, if you view the running positions, you will see that, hey, this slave account, it has three running positions. The same with your, with the other slave accounts. See? Because they were all copied from the master account. But what you can do is that you can specifically kill or close certain positions from this kill switch button right here. And a dialog box will appear. You just have to confirm it. Once you decided to, yes, you would like to close all these positions, this will only affect the closing of the positions on certain slave account. In this case, when you click yes, what was done is that the positions on this specific slave account will be closed. And if you would then check all other slave accounts, they are not affected at all. So they are still having their own positions running because, well, you only decided to kill or close the positions only for the slave account. Of course, if you would like to be extra safe, you can do it directly from the master account. So instead of closing the positions from the master account, you can also do it from the dashboard, like so. Now, since the positions are closed on the master account, we can expect that all these positions should also be closed on the slave account, right? So I think that's all. To read more about the features and also some more advanced customizations, I would strongly advise you to read the documentation page. It is located right here. So there's a lot of sections which you can read about, which would allow you to even customize the copier even further. I think that's all for me. Thank you for watching.